there are a lot of factors. You can overdose on certain vitamins, like if you have too much zinc, that's not a good thing. Greetings, fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com, and today I would like to talk a little bit about vitamins. Lately, I've gotten really interested in vitamins and how they affect our bodies. Now, I should preface this by saying that I am not a doctor, I am not a nutritionist, I have nothing to do with any science related to food or vitamins. This is just my opinion. I'm just basically using this video to talk things out, clear them out in my head, and hopefully get a discussion going because I'm really interested in this topic. My mother-in-law, my sister-in-law, and the girlfriend of my brother-in-law, they're all in the medical industry. So they tend to have very strong opinions about vitamins. Some of them think vitamins do absolutely nothing. And here I'm talking about the encapsulated vitamins that you can purchase. And others think that it's really important that we use them as supplements. Personally, my opinion has always been that they should be something that supplement your diet. That's why we call them supplements. They add on to what vitamins you're already getting through your food. And as such, I don't feel the need to get 100% of my daily recommended dose through vitamins. So if I have a capsule that has only, let's say, 20% of my daily dose, I'm happy with that because I do get a lot through my diet, through the food that I cook for myself and eat. Recently, I had a very heated conversation with someone who believes very strongly that vitamins are rubbish if they only have a small amount in them. So if you're only getting 10% of your daily recommended dose or 15%, then you shouldn't use them at all. And I guess that kind of makes sense if this is a vitamin that you are not getting in your diet. So for example, since I am a vegan, I do not get B12 from my diet, so I have to get it supplemented. So I need to get 100% of my recommended dose, otherwise I will then go through side effects. So I make sure that I get exactly the right amount that I need. I don't play around with those vitamins. But vitamins that I generally get a lot of through my diet, like vitamin C, iron, zinc, those I can be a lot more flexible with. If I already get, let's say, 50% or 75% of my vitamin C for the day through the things that I eat, does it really matter if the vitamin supplement that I'm using only has 10%? It's still 10% more than what I was getting before. And personally, I don't think that we have to get 100% of every vitamin that we need every single day. So if I only get up to 60% of vitamin C today, I can make that up tomorrow when I might go over, depending on what I eat. So for me, it's more of a weekly challenge. So I try to make sure that on average in the week, I get as much as I need and not worry too much about getting the right amount every single day, because that gets really difficult for me. If I have to cook something that has all of the things that I need and then also have all of the supplements on top of that, it's too much for me. I can't handle it. It's very stressful. So personally, I would like to float around the idea and see what you guys think, because possibly a lot of you out there are better qualified than me. You might be dietitians, you might be nutritionists, you might be doctors. I don't know. Let me know so that we can get a lot more educated between us. So if we all share our knowledge, hopefully we can get a little bit smarter as a result. Of course, let's try to be civil about it. I despise those online kerfuffles that happen in other videos. I don't want to see that going on in my videos. So I will probably delete you or report you if you get too rude. But there is some leeway there, obviously, if you're getting upset, but you're still being civil, that's fine. Anyway, I just wanted to put it out there because it's really hard to find information. There's a lot of information on both sides, and spending time online can plunge you into a rabbit hole sometimes, and you find a bubble that generally agrees with what you think, and then you get stuck in the bubble, and the bubble gets bigger, and you don't open yourself up to other information that might be useful in changing your opinion. What I'm trying to do here is to pop my bubble, to bring in information from other areas, and to take my information out into those areas too, so that we can all learn from each other. Something I'm very, very particular about is trying not to get caught up in the idea that just because I eat a vegan diet, that doesn't mean I have a perfectly healthy diet. I know a lot of plant-based people, vegan people, who assume that because they're eating whole foods plant-based, they get everything they need and they don't have to supplement, they don't need to track any of the vitamins in their food, and that they're fine. But a lot of the time, the issue becomes how much you eat as well. Even if all of the food you're eating is perfectly healthy stuff and it's all fresh fruits and vegetables and legumes, you may not eat enough of it, or you may not be absorbing it properly. So I do advocate for getting your blood tested and making sure that everything is in order, hopefully twice a year or so, at least at first, so that you can get a baseline and establish whether or not you need to supplement, because you may be okay. You may be getting all of the vitamins that you need through your diet. Personally, my family has an iron deficiency in general, so all of us do tend to not absorb it very well, even though we have a lot of it in our diet. So that's something that I supplement. But for you, it may not be necessary. You might be completely fine with iron. You might have an issue with magnesium or zinc or I don't know, whatever. I'm trying to say here that it's important to get personal with these things, not just to pick up a bottle or a jar of vitamins from the pharmacy and say, okay, well, this is something that's very popular, it should be fine, I'll take it. You might already have too much of a certain vitamin in your diet, and that particular vitamin brand might have a lot more in it than others, and you might end up having too much. And then a lot of it gets excreted from your body, and in an attempt to keep everything balanced, which means you're throwing money at something that's just getting wasted. There are a lot of factors. You can overdose on certain vitamins, like if you have too much zinc, that's not a good thing. You could just be throwing it away, like I said before, by letting your body excrete the excess. Or you might just be getting the wrong types that you don't need, and then not getting other types that you do need. Everyone is different, and everyone needs their own very particular cocktail. So put the time and effort into figuring out what that is. I've done a lot of blood tests over the last few years since going vegan to make sure that I'm doing things properly, to make sure I don't have any deficiencies, and I know which vitamins I need to be focusing on. And I also know how much of those I need to take. It's not something that I take lightly, and it's not something that I take randomly. So I don't advocate for that. I don't want anyone out there to just do no due diligence and just pick up things randomly and willy-nilly and then taking them. Vitamins are medicine. We need to be careful. They may be off the counter, which makes everyone think they're completely safe in all instances, but they're only safe if you use them properly. Even water is unsafe if you misuse it. You can have too much water. You can have too little water. You can drown in it. So you need to be careful. And this is another way that I would just like to warn people to just be a little more intentional. It doesn't hurt to put a little more time and effort into things. And then after that, once you get used to it, everything runs more smoothly. It may seem like a good idea to save time in the moment and rush into certain things, but in the long run, it can be really harmful. So anyway, that's my video for today. I hope you guys got something out of it. Please let me know if there's anything you want to share in the comments below. And I'll see you when I see you.